Okay, so here I've got a game object plugging into a setActive node, which is making it deactive. Now, what if I wanted to do this with a game object array instead, which is essentially just a list of game objects? Well, I'm unable to plug it directly into a setActive node, as a game object array is merely a list of game objects. Instead, what I have to do is I have to go through each individual object and set them to be setActive. We can grab a single game object from this array by doing gameObjectArray.get. And now that we have a game object, we can plug that into the setActive node. Now, this get node is currently grabbing the 0 slot on the array. If we just come over to our array, make it public, and then click on the game object that has the Udon script on it, we can come down to our game object and hit this little drop-down menu, and we can see the size of the game object array. Now, if I was to increase the size of this game object, so currently the game object array is getting the 0 slot in the game object. If I was to change this into 1, it would then get the 1 slot, and so on and so forth. Therefore, what we need to do is we need to go through all the objects from 0 to 7 in my case, as the array is 8 objects long, and we need to change the active state of each individual object to false. In order to cycle through all of these objects, we need to use a for loop. A for loop can be created by right-clicking, going get node 4. And we're left with this slightly daunting node. The way this works is that we have the start number, and it will count up until it reaches its end number. And we have this little step in that says how much it climbs each time. Default is 1, usually leave it at that. So if I make this end value 6, it will count 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and on the 6th note, it will play this exit value. So, if we would put the body into the setActive node, our current code will tell GameObject1 to turn off 6 times. Because this will play, 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and then on the 6th one, it will finally go off to the end. Now, a useful thing about this for loop is that we have this int index. This int index will tell us what number it's currently on. Now, we can grab this int index and chuck it into the get node, so that now each time it plays, it increments by 1, and therefore it will cycle through each object in our array. So, the first time it plays, it will grab the 0 game object, and then the for loop will increment by 1, and it'll say to get the 1 game object, and so on and so forth. So now our script, when played, will cycle through 0 to 5, turn off all those game objects in our array. So therefore, whenever we play this, it will turn off our first 6 game objects. So now, if I change this end node to 8, it'll go through all 8 game objects in our array. Okay, so now we have a way of cycling through all our game objects. However, we still have to go inside the code whenever we change the size of the array. What we really want is to be able to change this end int to be however big the array is for when we're using it. Now, we could just create a public end int and make the user have to change it to be the size of the array. However, there's a much better way of doing this. If we simply do a get node game object array dot get length, we now have a node that returns the size value of the array, which, in our case, is perfect. We just plug that into our end node, and now whenever we change the size of the array, it changes the amount of times that the for loop plays, allowing for us to loop through all of its components. Awesome! So hopefully that was helpful for you. Feel free to leave a like on the video if you liked it, leave a comment down below if you got any questions, and feel free to check out some of my other tutorials that I have on the channel. But until next time, bye!